Double trouble in the fight against H1N1 for local doctors' offices and hospitals. More sick people coming in, more sick employees going out.
And I have never seen a flu season like this flu season before.
Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
I'm Brandi Peterson. Doctors' offices and hospitals are already adjusting operations because their employees are sick.
All this as they await more H1N1 vaccine. KETV News Watch 7's Todd Andrews joins us live at the Nebraska Medical Center with our big story. Todd?
And Rob, we've just received word from the Douglas County Health Department that it has just received 4,000 additional doses of H1N1 vaccine. That's great news for places like the Nebraska Medical Center, which is dealing with increased numbers of flu patients as well as sick nurses.
At the Nebraska Medical Center, tools of the trade like instruments, supplies, and machines are at the ready for more H1N1 patients.
We're seeing about 20 extra people a day with flu-like symptoms.
A patient load that has even experienced nurses like Betsy Flood shaking their heads.
I have never seen a flu season like this flu season before. People feel horrible. It's for a long time. And the interesting thing is it's affecting younger people.
The center's ER got a brief reprieve from the added H1N1 pressures Thursday, but that was not the case at local health clinics.
Can you check me?
Where people filed in throughout the day to see doctors. Meantime, back at the Nebraska Medical Center, officials are dealing with a different challenge, sick employees.
We have had many, many people ill with the flu, up to 3 nurses a day.
We want our healthcare workers who are ill not to come to work, and everybody's policing everybody else, and I think that's worked very, very well.
In response, other ER staff have had to fill in to cover schedules, while doctors have taken to coming in an hour early to treat flu patients. And as far as H1N1 drug treatments are concerned, officials here say they've been getting about 200 doses of the H1N1 vaccine every Monday for the past several weeks, but right now there are no indications as to how many more they'll be getting next week. For now, center staff assure that they're doing all they can with what they have.
That's kind of a limited amount, but we're grateful for what we've been given.
As far as the breakdown of that latest shipment of H1N1 vaccine to the Douglas County Health Department goes, the only indications we're getting are from Creighton Med Center right now. Officials say they're set to receive 100 doses. They're not sure when they're going to get them, though. The health department says it will hold more flu vaccination clinics soon to distribute the new stuff, but they're not sure of what the dates are going to be for that, Rob.
All right, Todd Andrews reporting live. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Now, some peace of mind if you're pregnant and worried about getting flu vaccines. Yale University researchers say babies actually benefit when moms-to-be get the shots. 350 women participated in the study, which started in 2000. Women who got their flu shots had babies who were bigger, healthier, and less likely to be premature.